I'm Madwolf.
I'm Honest Puck.
And today we're doing a very special review. We're reviewing Ishafan TOMBAC.
Yes, it's TOMBAC.
It's TOMBAC.
I got this from Dark World to trade my first week on Hookah Pro. Saw it on Hookah Drum, got in chat, hey, has anyone tried this? Like, hey, I'll send you a sample. And I'm thinking it's like 50 grand, maybe a bowl's worth. He sends me an entire pack of this stuff. I'm like, oh, okay, awesome. And then like, well, that's all nice and dried out. Okay. Then I realized that's how it's supposed to be. And after that, just refer to our how-to video for prepping it for detail.
It takes a bit to get going. We've got 3 coals on it to get started. We're smoking out a 36-inch Egyptian with an Egyptian bowl. And it does take a bit to get started. You gotta get it baking going. But now that we've got it going, it actually produces medium-sized clouds. And the best way I could describe it would be a Nat Sherman.
It's really good cigarette tobacco.
Yeah, I mean, it does taste like cigarette tobacco, but it's like a really high-end, like Nat Sherman. It's a golden tobacco anyway, if you've ever seen this stuff. So that's about right. And yeah, it does taste like a Nat Sherman, basically.
Yeah. If you haven't had one, you can't think of another way to describe this. It's not bad. I'm not a cigarette smoker myself, but if I did smoke it, this would work.
I don't think I'd smoke it often.
I don't think you could.
Yeah, this stuff will kick you where it hurts. This stuff will get you lightheaded, a lot of nicotine, drink water, eat beforehand.
Yeah. If you're even remotely hungry, don't even think about going for this. It'll knock you out.
Yeah, this stuff's pretty intense.
This is way beyond Zag or DM or anything like that.
Yeah.
This is like the 80-year-old guy sitting out front smoking hookah, you know.
Yeah, this is, I mean, it's flavorful. It's a very, like I said, it's a very rich, light tobacco. Even like maybe a light Baccarat cigar. But I hate saying cigarette tobacco because a lot of people think like Marlboro or something like that. That's not what it is. It's like a real good light leaf tobacco, which they usually do use for high-end cigarettes, and they use for like certain cigars. It is an intense smoke. It's a little bit more harsh than most. You can't just sit here and super cheap it unless you want to die.
Yeah. You guys who enjoy hot boxing your hookahs, no. That's a good way to pick yourself on the floor for a couple hours. I smoke a briar. I smoke cigars. This is a lot more than that. This is.
Yeah.
There's no glycerin, no honey. This is. It's how we did Zag. You know, no glycerin, no honey. This is just the pure stuff.
Yeah.
You know, we saw in our how-to, we soaked it to get it, you know,
usable.
And evidently, some people just soak it in glycerin and smoke it like that. You are better men than we are, by far.
Like I said, it's actually. I don't want to sound like I'm knocking it. It's good. I'm enjoying this.
Just can't do it
more than once every couple months. It's intense.
Maybe once a week, depending. Like during the winter, good cold out, needs to, you know, to warm you up. I can see this doing it.
Then it also is labor intensive.
That's
another thing. I think maybe that's why it's like, it's a good smoke, but you have to do so much. You have to soak it and do all that to do it.
And possibly if you prep prep a lot of it, then.
I don't know, it'd dry out, and you have to redo it and everything. It's labor intensive. So, I think if you got one of those big bricks they sell, it'd last you as long as you'd ever. smoke, unless you just really like it. Like I said, I smoke cigars, I smoke pipe, all that kind of stuff. I like tobacco, and it's good, but it's not mind-blowing.
Yeah. I mean, it's not supposed to be, this isn't supposed to be the greatest you've ever tasted. This isn't supposed to be, you know, the best shisha or what have you ever. It's TOMBAC. It is what it is. It's there. It's simple. It's no frills.
This is basic.
Yeah, this is as simple as you can get.
Honestly, I'd rather smoke Zag. That's probably why I have my opinion towards it. Zag's easy. I like Black Cavendish, so there's that.
Now, as a mixer, I think you use this in your Jurok mix,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it does actually make good. If you want to make like a Jurok or something, it does really good base for that, actually. So you can use it to make stuff really well. So that is what it is good for very much. But just by itself, it's a very basic smoke. It's very labor intensive. So I would say it's worth a try if you can get a bit from somebody. It's not, you know, not undoable or anything. It's worth giving it a shot. And you might like it more than, you know, maybe I do. So.
And as you notice, GOTHKID isn't with us. A, he's at work. And
he's
B, the first time we tried to smoke this, he couldn't.
Yeah, well, it knocked us all out, actually, the first time he smoked it. So he respectfully declined passing out because of this. So. I think that does sum it up, though.
Yeah.
So, I'm Madwolf.
I'm Honest Puck.
Keep on smoking. Now you go die of horror.